to Casa de Cori, Casa de Luna, Casa de Coconut. All right, welcome back, guys. I'm excited to show you some transitioning from, I want to say like fall slash Halloween, Thanksgiving decor up until Christmas decorations, decorating your front door, your stoop. I'm just giving you a little bit of inspiration. Hopefully I'm early to get you guys so excited about the holiday season and getting your front door holiday ready. A lot of us are kind of like, well, what do I put outside? And whatever I put will probably, I mean, I live where it's cold. So a lot of you are probably thinking what I'm thinking. Whatever we put outside has to be weather resistant. It has to stand up to rain, to snow, to hail, to horses falling off the sky. God knows. Anyway, hopefully you guys will get some good inspiration from this video and get excited and ready about the holiday season. I absolutely love holidays. Everything, the glistening lights, the snow, the Christmas tree, the annoying Christmas music every time you go shopping. I love it all. So I'm very ready for it. And now let's get our stoop ready for it. Stay tuned. All right, guys, so we're gonna start by clearing out our area. A good tip is just grab a box, a bin, anything that you may have at home, and put all your decorations in them. As you can see, I put gloves on because through the months, all this stuff can get all kinds of gunk on it. Now, unless you're really limited for space, try not to throw your stuff away. You already paid good money for it this year. There's no sense in throwing it away. Pop it in a box, put it away for next year. For things that are a little bit more delicate, like wreaths, just make sure you're storing them very safely. Now, this is a quick DIY project that I want you guys to keep in mind when transitioning. We're gonna keep our pumpkins and put them aside because we're actually gonna reuse them for winter decorations. Now, don't forget to label the boxes of your decorations, stuff you're putting away. It just takes the guesswork out of trying to find your stuff next year. Give the area you're going to be working on just a quick sweep. You want to be working on a clean area, that way everything looks a lot better. And here's the official before shot. This is the centerpiece of our area, and you're not hallucinating. It was $9.99. Found these Christmas ornaments on clearance at Kmart. They are the Martha Stewart collection. Next, we're gonna go ahead and use this old box I had laying around the house. It's actually a cooler, but it's wooden. It's really pretty, and it gave me the height that I needed to put up my Christmas tree. The little green chair in the background, you'll see what I use that for in a minute. I'm also going to be using a brick to keep the tree stable. Now let's start some of our DIY transformations. This star I had gotten at Christmas tree shops for like $3 in the summertime, and it was blue and it matched my decorations then, but moving on, so I want it gold now. I happen to be using Krylon metallic gold spray paint. A quick coat would do. Project I was telling you all about. Let's recycle our pumpkins. They're still in pretty good condition. They're not rotting or anything. Mine happen to be real. You can use plastic ones as well. And just give them a good even coat of spray paint, color of your choice, whatever's going to match your decorations, and reuse them. I had two, so now on to the second one. Time to test for power. Now be careful with using extension cords and making sure that your power outlet is safe and weather resistant. Separate your branches. Start placing your ornaments in whichever order makes you happy. Quick tip, when you are putting your ornaments on the tree for outdoors, just make sure you secure them really good. I like to bend the little tree branch inward. I found this old tree skirt at a thrift store for $1. I couldn't give it up. Sticking anything on vinyl is pretty tough, so command strips seem to work just fine. Just just make sure your surface is clean. Now, time to accessorize. These are planters that I just used upside down. Be careful when unraveling your Christmas lights and always keep the little extra ones that it brings in case one burns out. These right here. Now I wanted to put Christmas lights going up the two front poles that I had, and I noticed that I didn't really need to put anything to keep them secured. They just kind of stuck. They just stayed on. If you need to add like a little bit of tape on the back side to make sure they stay, you're more than welcome to try that too. And this is what column one looks like. I think it's so pretty, the glistening lights. Keep in mind, it's very important to buy the Christmas lights that have the links that attach to each other. It just makes this process so much easier when you're trying to just continue on with the power rather than having to run power to where your extension starts every time. Now to keep these going across, I just used some scotch tape and it held it just fine. If you're gonna be hanging Christmas lights up poles like I did, just look at the other one before you start. That way they start in the same direction. And column number two is also complete. These cute reindeer cover my brick and also remind me of my four best friends. This is actually a kitchen mat I bought at Walmart. This beautiful wreath I found at TJ Maxx. Now, since I already had my Christmas box upstairs, I decided to kind of sprinkle some Christmas decorations throughout the living room. These are little items I've been collecting through yard sales and thrift shops and Walmart. Anything I can find on clearance, I pretty much buy it throughout the year. Reveal. I feel that my stoop is ready for the holidays. I feel like I get ready once my house is ready for the holidays. So up next, we are going to be doing decorating indoors for the holidays, putting up the Christmas tree. I'm excited to show you guys the colors I'm going to be using. It's a little bit different. It's a little bit outside the box, but most certainly it's going to be something you're going to definitely enjoy watching. So there you have it. I hope that you guys got to learn something. I don't want you to get discouraged if you don't have a stoop like I do and all you have is a front door in an apartment building and a little tiny space to put your mat on. I do want you to try something, get creative. At the end of the day, your front door is a reflection of your personality and those who live inside your home. And finally, if you're putting a Christmas tree outdoors like I did, make sure you put something to put weight on the feet because it gets windy and Christmas trees fall over and your ornaments break. It happened to me. Thank you for watching. Tell your friends, to tell their mama, to share, like, subscribe. It's been a pleasure. See you all next time. Bye.
I remember being young and so brave. I knew what I needed. I was spending all my nights.
Shut your car off and don't talk and don't slam your door.
Bye.
Recording outside sucks.
It's so cold.
You ready? Are you gonna record now?
Recording.